Hi, this is Raksil and you are watching Raksil DS777's channel, and this video is the custom ROM review of Project Elixir. Now let's go to settings, about phone, Project Elixir, double tap, and let's turn to 13. And here you can see the Android 13 logo here. You get the latest Soviet Star update from October 31st, and the SE Linux status is enforcing, which is good. And this is the settings. We are in the settings, and you can see Essence right here. In here, you get the customization for your themes, lock screen, status bar, quick settings, and gesture miscellaneous. In themes, you get body font, you get tons of fonts style here, and icon packs, signal icons. In lock screen, you will get UDFPS animation. These are the UDFPS animation, and I have enabled Cyberpunk 2077. And you get icon pickers for UDFPS for your fingerprint. Alright, you can check out the fingerprint, and this is the fingerprint icon, and see the animation. See the fingerprint, it's fast and smooth, right? You also get screen of UDFPS. Let's try this. And screen of UDFPS is working fine. Alright. Now in here you get media cover art, height status bar, lock screen, charging info. And in quick settings, you get QS customization, you get classic style, outline, maybe rectangle style. I have enabled classic style. This is how it looks, the quick setting panels. You get background transparency for your quick setting panels, and I have enabled the transparency for, I have set 21%, and it's working, right? And you can see the battery state here from Franco Control Manager. Screen on time 6 hours 29 minutes, 124% consume, and screen of 7 hours 58 minutes, 9% consume. I played game for like half an hour in this battery stage, and my battery is not that good. You know, my battery percentage, my current battery mAh is 2000 mAh, so this is the good battery backup result, right? For 6 hours 29 minutes, 124%. If your battery is good enough, then it will give you much better battery backup, better than this. Alright, and now in gestures, you get swipe to screenshot, three finger screenshot, and touch screen gestures. Three finger screenshot, it's working fine. And in miscellaneous, you get ignore window, secure flags, and you get advanced restart option, unlock higher FPS in games, and hide icons of Essence, and game space is there. Yeah, you have already seen this, so I'm not going through this. In display, you will see extra dim and color, natural boosted, saturated, adaptive. You get DC dimming, high brightness mode under display. Okay, now in, we are back to home screen, and let's see the home settings. This is the Pixel launcher. You get at a glance option, wallpapers and style. In wallpapers and style, you see you get theme icons, and the theme icon is enabled and it's working fine with us, right? In widgets, you get Android S Easter egg. Okay, you also get your YouTube widgets here. Okay, now in DRM info, you get security level L1, wideband CDM, this is the Geekbench score here. Single score 730 and the multi score is 2562. And this is the CPU throttling test, ran for 6 minutes 7 seconds, and the max GIPS is 201k and the average is 191k GIPS, minimum 175k GIPS, which is good, right? And let's go to Play Store about, and you get Play Store devices certified out of the box, okay? But here in this custom ROM you will not find camera here, but here I have installed LMC 8.4 here, which is a very good camera. You can find this camera, you can install this. I will leave the link in the description. Okay, now let's test safety net here. Run the test. Safety net all profile is success and passed by default, so there is no problem with your banking application. You can use them without any worries. Now let's go to quick settings panel. This is how it looks. Let's go to more edits. You get DC dimming, extra dim. Alright, you get one-handed mode. You get sound amplifier. This is sound amplifier here. Okay. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Keep smiling. Stay safe. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace out. Goodbye.